Oh, no. just taking control of me. And I am never found so relieved. And it burns just knowing we'll all lose sleep. For once in our whole lives, it had to see. So now we'll go to a place that we can always call our home. And now we'll go. How's it going, everybody? I'm Dedicated Stone, aka James, and this is a haul portion of my video. Now, I'm filming this part before I go toy and game hunting tomorrow in the Tri-Cities, which is in Washington State. And this is stuff I found over the last couple days at my local Value Village, Goodwills, Toys R Us, etc., as well as the Ellensburg, Washington Goodwill and a Habitat for Humanity thrift store. And a comic book store also in called Central City Comics, also in Ellensburg. Now let me go through all my finds. First off, at the Habitat for Humanity, I ended up finding this for $3. Which, if you don't know what it is actually a Power Rangers in Space Megazord. You can see his little face up in there. I'm not going to transform him. I'm not going to transform him just because of the fact that he's really hard to put back to normal. Let me pick these up. Also from that resort, I ended up picking up for $1.50. Now that was priced at $3 for that Megazord. I picked up for $1.50 a copy of Shrek 2 on the GameCube. It is complete. I picked it up just because in my area, GameCube games are really hard to come across. Also, something I picked up yesterday at that Central City Comics. Now, it was a buy three, get one free deal. The free one I got was a Scarecrow and Popster. I gave that to my father. Now, what I ended up picking up, for $12 each, Gizmo. Laying back there. From Child's Play 2, I picked up Chucky for my horror pops. And one of the Gremlins. I think that was about it. Oh, there's a few more things. From the Goodwill over in Ellensburg, I also picked up, these are all $2.99 each, a copy of Rayman on the PS1. They're in okay so-so condition. They're all complete. The next Tetris on PS1. And just for the heck of it, I picked up SimCity 2000. Also yesterday, I picked up... Yesterday, as in, not... Today's Friday. Yesterday was Thursday. The, 12th. I picked up Armyman 3D. From my local... It was $2.99. It was from my local Salvation Army. A few days ago, I bought WWE 2K17, brand new, $40 from a Walmart, as well as Fallout 3 from the same Walmart. From GameStop, I bought a brand new Pokemon Sun, which is okay, I guess. It's not the greatest game, so. Today, from a local Value Village, so I can get rid of this, I picked up a bunch of Pokemon cards. Nothing too exciting in there, but there's some Japanese cards in there too. One thing, just kind of out of order, one thing I found yesterday was a Jetfire Transformer. Now, he is missing some vital parts, so I can't have him in vehicle mode properly because he does not look right. But it's fine. He looks just fine right here, and he is worth about $100 or so. So in that condition, I would probably value him at like $60 to $80. And I only paid $7.99 for him. Since they do this at Goodwill and they do like you build your own bag of toys for $5, I ended up finding another Transformer here. His head's right there. Found him and a whole bunch of random toys. None of them are really wow. around. Let's go on to, still yesterday. At that same Goodwill that I found all those PS1 games, I picked up a brand new copy of Fallout New Vegas on PS3. I've been wanting to get into the Fallout games, and what better way than Fallout 3 and then New Vegas. At the Lighthouse Shop, which is another little thrift store here in Yakima, I picked up a copy of Devil May Cry 4 and Final Fantasy 13 on PS3. $3.25 each for those two. And I have one more thing. I picked up this cool little knick-knack chest. It has a little dragon on the top, and it opens up. This is $6. And in my mind, it's pretty much worth it. Now, going on to today. On my first stop, I picked up Slinky Dog for my Toy Story collection, and his Slinky is perfect. Let's see here. I also picked up for $2.99 a copy of Fable: The Lost Chapters. I didn't go in there and record because I didn't think I was going to find anything today, but it turned out I should have recorded. I found a whole bunch of games. Nothing too wow, but still. And I also picked up a Xbox 360 cord, just so I have extras lying around. Come back to that. Come back. Okay, at Value Village, the same Value Village I found that Jetfire at, I've got a copy of 007 Nightfire. It is complete in box. The only thing is, the disc is not a greatest hits disc. It's a black label disc, which is fine. As complete's complete. It's all good. That was on $3.99 for $5.99 or $3.99 again. I got a Griffin, little Griffin toy. Looks kind of cool. Be a cool little display piece. Anything else? Oh, from one of my local Walmarts, I got Chris Jericho. I didn't get him for the Chris Jericho. I mostly got it for the highlight reel, but I needed a more modern Chris Jericho. Back to that Value Village, I also picked up for $10 a piece. I got Beetleborgs, Deluxe Transforming Beetles. This one's Boron. And then I got the only other one that was released, Roboborg. So I got both of those complete in box. The stickers weren't put on, so I put the stickers on just now. But everything's in there, the sword and the robot. I looked those up. They go for at least $40. I went to Toppenish, Washington, because I was looking for some PS1 games, and some PlayStation games. So I went over there, see what he had, and he had a few things I was looking for. The PlayStation game I bought for $10 was Small Soldiers. I needed the back cover art because mine has the wrong back cover art. So I figured, you know what, $10 is how much I'll end up having to pay for it later on to get it complete. I also picked up a copy of Metal Gear Solid 4 for $5. It was okay. It's about what I would pay for it, $2.99 to $5. And then also for $5, Unreal Tournament 3. Out our local Walgreens, I went through all of them. They didn't really have anything, but I picked up the Walgreens exclusive Daredevil for $14.99 using their little sale that they had going on. So I figured that was a good deal. I was going to pick up a Namor 2, but they didn't have one at that one. Another one, I'm not sure if they even have this sale going on, so I didn't want to risk it. Also, one of my Goodwills, I ended up finding for $2.99 a WWE Raw ring. I have a WCW ring, but I don't have a WWE Raw ring, so that'll be a nice little change-up. Make sure there's nothing else that I'm missing. Also from that same Goodwill, I picked up a Mr. Bill bendable figure. He's going to stay in his packaging. There's no point bringing him out. If you don't know who he is, I grew up with him being in the beginning of some of the Ernest movies. But, you know, he's just a cute little, cool little vintage figure. And from the Build Your Own Toy things, I got I don't know what this is. I'm assuming it's a Dorb, an alien Dorb or something. I don't know what it is. If you guys know, please let me know. But he looks kind of cool. I picked this up for the heck of it, an octopus. Kind of cool. I don't know if I'll keep it or not. They had a bunch of these Power Ranger figs in here. So So I picked up all the ones I could find. I got this one. I'm assuming it's from Samurai. But, so I got the body. And I'll get through all of them once I find them. I got a Optimus Prime Funko Pop. That was kind of cool. I only bought two bags, so I paid, what is it, $5 times two. So, a little bone dinosaur. It's kind of tight. Probably won't keep that one. I got a World and Nintendo figure here. I got a... Let me pose them properly. I got a Donkey Kong. It's kind of cool. Don't ever see those around a lot. I got a Incredible Hulk. I don't know what exactly he is. I know he's a statue of some sorts. But, yeah. Got a nice little Hulk. I got a Transformer here. It looks like he transforms into a tank. I don't know if he's all there or not. He probably isn't. But I'll put him together to see how much of him is there. I got this guy, the Fox from Zootopia. The same thing. I don't know if he's all there. It's a little bumblebee. I got a Hound. I'm going to use him to try to see if I can complete the figure that I got. The other one I got of him. I got a leg for the Power Ranger. So if I do it right, I think it's the... I think it's that leg. Could be wrong, and it could be the other leg. I don't know. Got some Lego pieces. I got a droid, Star Wars droid. Got this Transformer. Don't know what he transforms into. I got the head for the Mastodon, the Legacy Collection head. So that's kind of cool. I couldn't find the rest of him there, so got what I could find. I also got the Triceratops from the Legacy Collection. It's missing the other horn. It's fine, though. I'm not going to worry about it. Got this piece. I'm assuming it's another foot. A little Transformer fig. Assuming it's a one-step changer. Yep, it is. The one-step changer. I got this cool little wolf thing. I don't know what he's from, but he looks kind of cool. Pretty sick. Another Power Ranger fig. I got a bird dragon. Another piece. I don't think it's all there, but I just got what I could find. I got a Deadpool Funko Pop. There's a couple there's at least one Bakugan. A little tiny Optimus. Another little tiny Optimus. I'm guessing it's like a G1 Optimus or something, but it's kind of cool. A couple more pieces for the Zords. And finally, I got a Clefairy top and a Squirtle. Anyway, if I find more stamps tomorrow, I'm going to put it on the end of this haul video, too. I'm going to try to catch some footage, and I'll put it on the front. So, until then, signing off. How's it going, everybody? This is another part of my haul video. I didn't do any recording, mostly because of the fact that, you know, there's nothing too wow. I did leave a Lara Croft Tomb Raider toy out in the car. But I just bought it for resale purposes. I bought it for like $4 or $5. So don't worry about that. But anyway, I got a package in the mail from Amazon. It should be a set of wrestlers battle pack. And it is. Not brand new. Well, it's damaged like they said it was. That's why I got it for cheap. Got it for about $12. It is Charlotte and Ric Flair with the World Heavyweight Championship. Now I got a lot of this. That's the only thing I got online. The rest of this is from Tri-Cities, random Hot Topic. And I don't think I bought any at Hot Topic. GameStop and a bunch of GameStops and more GameStops and Walgreens. But anyway, at one of the GameStops, the last one I went to, I found a Funko Pop. It was the Superman False God statue, for summer SDC summer convention exclusive. At Walgreens, I found another 8-bit that I needed, the classic Mario. I'm only missing two now. Pack of toys, not going to go through that. Plug and play, not going to go through that. I got some games here that I got from GameStop. I got Kingdom Hearts 1.5 Remix. Now, I have this game already in my collection. I just wanted the art book. I'm a big Kingdom Hearts fan. And I also got Blue Dragon. I got that from the Yakima GameStop. Now, onto this bag. I got Bulletstorm Epic Edition for $5. All these are complete, unless otherwise said. Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zeroes, $10. And Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. I had to go all the way to Tri-Cities to find this game. That was $20. Avengers Battle for Earth. One more Kinect game that I'm looking for now. And I got this using the half off when it's that Superman. For $5.99, I've got a Frieza Funko Pop. At a Walgreens, I found a Batista. Random ass Batista. More games from GameStop. I got Asura's Wrath, finally. Last time I found that game, they didn't have it. Metroid Other M, now my Wii Metroid collection is finished. Now I ended up buying some games and I returned them just because I needed some manuals. Zone of the Enders manual. And Super Mario Strikers Charged. Or just Mario Strikers Charged. Alright, let's go on to this bag. Let's see. From a Walmart, I got Left 4 Dead 2, $15. From a, I think this was Toys R Us. No, it was a random Target. I got the rest of the starters that I needed. I only wanted Gen 1 starters, first and second evolution. And from that same Target, I ended up getting another battle pack, Luke Harper and Eric Rowan with the sheep mask. From Game Store, this is stuff that I ended up buying an AJ Lee wrestler elite for $30, and then funny story, I'll get to it later. I ended up returning that same elite, and so pretty much I ended up getting $30 store credit. I ended up getting a Mario Paint strategy guide. That's why I got that Metal Gear Solid 5, is because I gave the strategy guide to my friend who was with me, and yeah, that was just to pay me back for that. But for $4.99, I got Gears of War 1 strategy guide. Now, I don't really use strategy guides. I just like having them, just in case. And I got Left 4 Dead 1. That's why I ended up buying Left 4 Dead 2. This was $14.99 too. From a toy store, or a hobby store, I guess, comic book store, I ended up getting Black Cat. I wanted the Marvel Legends, but I just have such a hard time finding her. So I went ahead and jumped on this for $25. Random Walgreens. This is why I returned that AJ Lee. I found an AJ Lee for $12.99. It's in really bad condition, the boxes, but I'm taking her out of the package. And from that same Walgreens, I ended up finding the Great Khali. And I also found White Link. And using their cell, I ended up coming across for $14.99. Namor, Walgreens exclusive. Good find. Yeah. From Walmart, I ended up buying Bray Wyatt to complete my Wyatt family. Now all I really need is Eric Rowan. I found him, but you know what? I'm trying to find the, not Eric Rowan, but Braun Strowman. they were having a sale on some of the Captain America wave of Marvel Legends. I picked three of them out. I got the Winter Soldier, and these ring up, him and Falcon ring up at $20. So I made a point that they were marked at 15. And here's Falcon. And the other one, only other one I got, like I would have got, who was it? Scarlet Witch if they had her, or Black Panther. I wasn't really looking for the Black Panther though, so I didn't get him. But I got Nick Fury. That was cool. Three Marvel Legends that really weren't on my list. From the game store that I ended up returning that game for at AJ Lee for, I bought WWE Crash Hour. I'm not keeping this. I'm going to give whichever copy is in worse condition to my friend, because I need a complete copy. And X-Men Legends. This was $7.99 and $4.99. And also for $30, I ended up getting, I overpaid by $5, so it's not that bad. I ended up getting another battle pack, Dolph Ziggler and Vicky Guerrero. Mostly got it for Vicky Guerrero, and I guess she's more common than I thought. And finally, that Toys R Us, I started off the day saying I really want that new Ash Greninja, and I found an Ash Greninja for $16.99, so I picked him up. I wasn't going to let him slide. To go with my Syndrome, I bought a Mr. Incredible, $6.98. And to finish up this set, I bought a Steel to go with the rest of my Return of Superman toys. And then I finally found a freaking Warthog Hot Wheels that I've been looking for a while. Anyway, that's going to be my haul video. I'm sorry I didn't have any toy or video game hunting live. But I already did one, and I don't want to do another one this soon. So if you like this video, leave a comment down below. Like this video, subscribe, click that notification bell if you're watching this on a mobile device, so that you get notifications of new videos. And like always, take care. And I just wanted to tell you guys that I am the new FAG, Freaking Awesome Games, YouTube Heavyweight Champion. Anyway, signing off. This is Dedicated Stone 5. See you on the next video.